Hello everyone watching. Welcome to Champions Online with Suhas Vedam, brought to you by Crackbus. Today we have with us yet another superb champion, Mr. Vinayak Saman. Man who played for Mumbai in Ranji Trophy and kept wickets, a lot of dismissals to his name, and of course is now the head coach of the Mumbai Ranji team. He loves to see blooming and blossoming of cricketers from Mumbai. Very warm welcome, Mr. Vinayak.
Thank you Suhas, and I'm glad to be here on this occasion and very happy.
So the next one would be 0 for 5. Rohit Sharma comes back to the pavilion. You're all padded up and you go in. What are you thinking? 0 for 5, half the side, and it's nullified, no runs on the board.
Yeah, actually that wicket was very tough to bat, actually, because green top with cracks. Rakesh Patel was in form, Irfan Pathan was there, Yusuf was there. So they have a very good bowling side. And in first inning also I batted well. I scored 21 run. So I spent a lot of time with Amol, and I got out. One ball kept low and I bowled. I got out bowled. So I knew how wicket is behaving. So yes, pressure was there. So I cut down my all shots. I was only defending, leaving the ball, and playing close to the body. So actually, crucial point is what? Penal Shah dropped one catch that match. That is the crucial point for the match.
Okay.
Yeah, because I was there and Wilkin Mota came in. So I told Wilkin that, you don't have to play, offer any kind of shot, even though full toss ball. Your mindset should be like, I have to defend only, even though, and it is for 1 hour or maybe half an hour or 1 hour. Restrict
so
yourself.
Playing time.
Yeah. So actually we have to stay on the wicket usually, because wicket was so dangerous. Because the ball, Rakesh Patel is bowling outswing, and he's releasing the ball out for outswing, and ball after pitching ball comes in sharp because of that crack, and crack is exactly in front of wicket. So that's why if your bat will go away from your body, but always that channel will open, and when channel will open, you'll get out either snake or inside edge bowled or bowled or leg before. So it is very difficult to play shots, and exactly he played opposite. He played that square cut, like half square cut, and easy caught behind. He dropped, Penal Shah dropped that catch when he was on zero. Wilkin was on zero, and after that I gave him bamboo, big bamboo. And I told him that this is the time to become a hero. Don't show your wicket to these buggers. Just go and focus on only defending ball. You will not get out. I'll tell you, you will not get out. Then after that, we discussed a lot of things, how to play and how to play this bowler, how to play that bowler. And then that partnership was built. So, and we went to end of days, we went to good total, which we can defend, our bowlers can defend easily. So that is the whole scenario, actually.
So when you're batting as well, were you thinking this looks like a minefield and less of a wicket, it's less of a pitch, would you keep karna padega? Are you thinking that?
No. Because I was the keeper who enjoys challenges, who enjoys turning track, who enjoys this bad bounce. So keeping is not an issue for me. I was always ready to keep wickets on any kind of wickets, because I was very confident about my keeping skills. Yes, batting skills I was a bit sometimes struggling with the seaming ball, or so I have to tell myself, play close to the body and so. But keeping wise, I was very confident. So there's, and fitness wise, I was always there. So fitness, I'm not anytime scared for keeping wickets.
Okay. So, you must have had counter signs with the bowler. Someone like Sairaj Bhatule tells you, if I rub my nose, it's going to be a quicker one. Aisa kuch tha while keeping?
Not really. Because when it's happened, when you know, you don't know the action, or you don't know the, you know, what bowler is bowling going to do. So okay. that is I was usually using you know, watching his hand or his steps, how fast he's coming, or any bowler how slow he's coming. So that is difficult for some kind of bowler, like maybe Kuldeep Yadav, you know, Chinaman. Your wrist can't see. If he is going faster, you can't see the wrist. Then it's okay to tell bowler if you're going to. But no, that has not happened any time.
So you had the perfect skills to be a wonderful keeper, of course. But there's one more skill that's added in the book sets these days: sledging. Did you do that?
Yes. That is actually. I would love to do that, because that is an art. That is an art. Oh, to sledge. Yeah. It is not.
That's why incident with you.
I got Gautam Gambhir out in one crunch match. He was scoring runs, and the match against Delhi at Jamia Millia College.
Jamia Ground.
Bhopal. Yeah.
Yes.
And we lost the toss. We batted first, wicket was bit damp. Myself and Bhavin Thakkar scored runs in that match. And we played well, and we put a good total on the board. And Gautam Gambhir was, you know, playing well. And one catch was dropped by Bhavin. He played reverse sweep, and Bhavin Thakkar dropped catch on the point sitter.
Okay.
And after that, he was, you know, going for each and every shot. And one ball he defended for Ramesh Pawar. Then I appealed. The ball, you know, was on the pad outside off stump. I appealed, and he came back to me and just he looked me. And then I saw now there is a chance to thoda sa isko anger dene ke liye. So again, next ball he played inside edge and pad. I appealed again. How was that? And he again bit scattered, and he's looking at me. When he looked at me, I knew that now something is going to happen. So third ball, he defended right to middle of the bat, and then I appealed like, oh god, yeah.
Okay.
Then I told him that fucking he's India player and he's defending the ball. He was kapat gaya lagta hai. So that I word exchange. So then over ho gaya. Then he played two shots for Nilesh Kulkarni mid wicket, and then next over again Ramesh Pawar, again he bowled and he played. I told him, "Arey yaar, isko maar sakta, isko nahi maar sakta." So like left arm spinner ko maarna easy hai, off spinner ko thodi maarega ye. Aisa gali deke baat kiya, thoda sa usko uksaya. Then he came to me and usne bhi gali diya. Maine bhi gali diya, mila tera kaam kar saale, chal. And then it's kicked off, and he played one big hit, and second ball he got out. So
it was a process.
Yeah, it's a process. It is not one time. This is like a lot of incidents, you know. One player from Vidarbha, who went to play for Hyderabad, yes, Watekar, one off spinner, opening batsman. So he used to play, you know, he used to mark a crease, like cross and then 1, 2, 3, 4 and going and tapping and coming again. So I saw, I saw that, and then I played with the mind game. When he used to do that 1, 2, 3, 4 and tapping this and going up it, I came there, I told them that chogri is cross, I put it cross with my leg.
Yeah.
So he was, he was like, what are you doing? Yeah, don't do this. Then I, why do you, why are you doing
this?
So I was playing with his mind. And when he did that, I did that twice, thrice. After third time, he got out. So it is like, you know, how you have to manage the things, or how you have to, you know, not by telling bad words or telling sledging is an art.
Who was your best friend when it came to sledging, in the sense partner in crime?
No. Because see, for sledging you have a lot of courage.
Okay.
Because no one short leg silly point fielder, they want to you know, tell directly to the batsman, because they want to come again and bat with again that 11 against against 11. So you need a lot of courage to sledge, because when you are telling you know, sledging alone, then whole team is going to sledge you. So that pressure have to take. So you need a lot of, so that's why a lot of wicket keepers or closing fielders, they are not telling anything for anything to batsmen.
Okay. So which wicket keeper excites you the most in Ranji Trophy cricket at the moment, and then in at the international level as well? Which one cricketer, if you would have?
Now wicket keepers, they are more batsmen wicket keepers. So I'm not finding really, except Saha. I'm not finding a good wicket keepers who used to bat. There's all batsmen, batsmen who used to wicket keeping a wicket. So batsman wicket keeping for one day 2020, it is okay, but days match you have to have a good wicket keepers who bats well, because well, right now what's happened, we are looking up for batting perspectives, but when I used to keep wickets, I used to win the match with taking a lot of catches and stumping and runouts. So that that mindset is not there for the day's game from the coaches or the selection committee. So they are backing always, you know, good batsmen who keep wickets. So I'm looking for only, you know, those who are good wicket keepers, or especially for day's match. Yeah, and obviously fit wicket keepers.
So you're fine with KL Rahul in the shorter formats keeping wickets as well, and then being the batsman that he is.
Yeah, but KL Rahul is a good wicket keeper, no doubt. He got a good hands, hands and balance. Then Rishabh Pant. Because Rishabh Pant is having a good batsman, but Rishabh Pant is not balanced. He's standing up quickly and not with the ball. But KL Rahul got a good skills. But I'm telling you that batsman wicket keeper slot for one day and 2020, it is okay, but not for day's game.
What do you think about Dhoni, sir? The career he had in tests as well as a keeper.
Yes. That's a good question, actually. Dhoni is a very smart cricketer. Very smart cricketer. And if you know, he improved his wicket keeping after representing India. So he knew that I have to work on my wicket keeping skills, or my gathering, or my, you know, anticipation. He's an anticipator cricketer. Like he anticipates well. Wicket keeping is an art of anticipation, because lot of dismissals, if you anticipate before getting out, before coming to you, it will be more easier to take stumping. It will be more easier to take catches. And he is a good anticipator. Dhoni is. And that's why he knew that his ball is going to come me somewhere here. Or this ball, this stumping now is going to step out. So I'm ready. So he's a good anticipator. And obviously, because of his smartness, he's, you know, he improved a lot. And he's really, really did well for India, or as a keeper, as a batsman, as a captain. But as a keeper, I'm telling you, he's a better wicket keeper.
Now, let me take you to the next section. Then.
Yeah.
We'll be showing you a few pictures and you can go down the memory lane and tell us a story around it.
Okay.
All right, sir?
Yeah.
Yes.
You stop. All right, yeah. That match is we played against UP at Indore
with Waseem Jaffer lifting
we won the Ranji Trophy against UP in final, which I scored 100 in that game.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Second inning
100. Yes. So yeah, it was a great match. Playing against all Indian attack, Bhuvi, RP and Bhuvi, RP, Piyush Chawla and the in-swinger. So all Indian attacks. So I scored 100. So happy for that in the final.
Yes, sir. And this is just a continuation of it, isn't it? Remember this inning?
Yeah, this inning is very special for me because this is my last match inning. We were struggling in final, yes, in first inning, and I scored some 70 odd runs on that seeming track.
I think 67.
67, yes, track, yeah, 67, versus, yes.
Yeah.
Against Kerala. Against
Kerala?
Karnataka.
Yes, Karnataka. Robin Uthappa was playing for Karnataka.
Yes, Karnataka. And that was my career's last match.
Career's last?
Yeah.
So, what about this? You remember when this photograph was played?
So that is CCI, Cricket Club of or England. Okay. I was captaining that time.
And how was the experience as a skipper?
Yeah, great experience, because when I was used to lead CCI, in 1 year out of six tournament, we won five tournament.
Five, okay.
Yes.
Brilliant.
Including Singapore 2020, International Club 2020 also.
Okay.
So it was good year. Oh, it's in Kenya. Kenya, this was a very great experience actually. We played match on, that army based, that wicket was the plastic wicket, synthetic wicket, okay. Joint wicket, yeah. And all over, there is no any grass on that outfield. So that is matting wicket, actually plastic matting wicket in Kenya, and we played with this all Zulus and all
Masai
that
Mara.
The traditional Masai Mara traditional cricketers.
Okay.
They are all upcoming cricketers. So very great experience. All right, yeah. This is with Gary Kirsten. Yeah, I got it in 2004-05, I think. I went with Sagar Chhabria. I was teaching him, we both of us we went to meet Gary Kirsten in his academy, and we've been there for at least 28 days.
Okay.
30 days we are there with Gary Christian and his group. It was great experience. Actually, I was happy with Gary that, whatever I used to tell the batsman, same skills, same conversation he was taking with that lad. So I was I was very happy that, I was very close to, and he told me that, all the things I learned from Sachin Tendulkar, that Gary told me. So, So I was very happy that, I was somewhere closer to Gary Kirsten skill-wise.
So now I'll show you a picture with a man who's owning ODI cricket at the moment, if you ask me.
Wow. He's amazing. Rohit Sharma, that's the same match, UP match when I scored 100 in second inning. He also scored 100 in that inning.
Yes, sir.
I never saw a batsman who looked so easy.
Okay.
So easy. Amazing. Means, again, I'm telling you that it is not a talent. It is his hard work, Rohit's hard work. But he got that extra time to pick up the ball because he's in good solid position. It's very, very good solid position. And that's why that makes him very special. But he's very hardworking.
You spotted the spark in him early, isn't it? When you were playing with him. What was the chat in the middle?
No. He's like a funny guy. He's not, focusing on only the situation. He was just only watching the ball and playing. But nothing much. He's usually enjoying cricket. That's it. He's a person like enjoy every moment. That's why he's very successful with Mumbai Indians. He's the captain in Mumbai Indians. He's very successful. He's captain in India. He's very successful.
Yeah.
So he's enjoying his cricket and he's very. Very unique actually. Rohit is very unique.
You happy with the way he's handled Shivam Dubey? You happy with that? Another?
No. See, he's knack of handling everyone.
Okay.
He got that captaining skill.
Okay.
That no one is having that easily. I'm telling you, Sachin Tendulkar was also very good captain, but somehow he failed. The great, the god of cricket failed with the captaincy. Because he's thinking, the captain's matching that thinking is not easy. Sachin's thinking, to go to his thinking is not easy. Because his thinking is...
Is it one of the problems of being Sachin Tendulkar, as people say very commonly?
No, because he...
You just don't have anybody else to compare yourself.
No, because I told you that his thinking is too ahead. So, I can't match my thinking with his thinking.
Right.
So, he's so passionate about each and every match, each and every ball. I'm telling you, in this incident, I'm telling you, We were playing match against Bengal final.
Okay.
So at Wankhede, and
Deep Das Gupta the keeper. That one.
Yeah, that one.
Okay.
Yeah. Rohan Gavaskar and Manoj Tiwari scored runs and chasing the target.
Yes.
In some of the time we were struggling. Each ball, Sachin was telling Amol, do this. Amol, five-step player, this cover should be here. Tell him to do this, do that. And Amol was a bit angry. He's telling me, and one catch went to Amol's hand and he dropped it. And after that, Amol went to covers. He told Sachin to come in slip. So it is like that. He was, Sachin was telling him each and every small thing, and he's out of the game. And he dropped that
catch.
Yeah, so the thinking is that touching Sachin's views or Sachin's perceptions are not easy. Not easy.
It's fine if you're not a successful captain, if you have 100 centuries to throw and then you've inspired
unfortunately,
a generation of cricketers.
Unfortunately, that match fixings also happened with in that his. So one of the reason of
the seam cleaning incident.
Yeah. So one of the reason he was
That's okay.
Yeah.
So one question that I always wanted to ask you is, so what do you think about the art of shepherding the tail, batting with the tail enders?
I'm so fortunate that I was batting with Ajit Agarkar. Ramesh Pawar was there, Sai Raj was there, there. So they are all batsmen. Those were bowler, but they got a batting skills. So whenever I chipped in, this all the either one top order batsman was playing with me, or maybe Ramesh or maybe Ajit was there with me. So after we always partnershiped in 6, 7, 8, 9. So that is the whole area. We either me and Ramesh, either me and Sai, either Sai and Ajit, either Ajit or me. So and in crunch situation, I used to play a lot because I love to play in that crunch situation. So all the time, I was there in a crunch situation. With Ramesh, with Ajit, with Sai, so playing with them, it's like they are better batsmen. Even Ajit scored 100 in Lords.
He has a century.
He's a tremendous good. He's a damn good batsman. So I don't have to worry about he'll get out or Ramesh will get out or Sai will get out. Yeah, I have to think after that. Like when I'm playing with 10 and 11. So after 10, what my role is? When 11 comes, then what my role is? So when number 10 batsman will there, I used to take singles, doubles, and I rotate strike. When 11 comes, then I will take strike only, and I used to either one or two boundary or last ball one run, and get them hardly. To play one or two balls, not more than one ball. So that is the strategy because I used to play with lower order only. So that is I used to that. So that is not tough to me.
So, but then you were asked to open with Waseem Jaffar, sir. Tell us a bit about Waseem Jaffar, sir, and then the opportunity to open batting with him, and you're not a number six batsman anymore.
That's a great incident for my life. To establish as the opening batsman, because I know the Praveen Amre was a coach, and Waseem was a captain. So I was playing, throughout the season. I was living ball well. I was playing ball well. So what happened that particular year? Sahil Kukreja, who used to bat, who used to open, but somehow he's getting out early in first inning. And he's scoring in second inning. So always we are struggling in first inning. So after four games, Abhishek Nair was unfit. So he's going to join the team. So with the combination, they came to this point that who's going to open now. Because to manage Abhijit Nair, number 5 or 6.
So okay, Abhishek
are 5 or maybe 4 or 5. So who is going to? Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is fixed. Because Rohit Sharma was there, Ajinkya was there. So everything is fixed. The 5 number will Abhishek Nair. So now, if he'll come, so who is going to drop out? So they went to this option that Vinayak will open the inning and will drop Sahil Kukreja because he is not used to score in first inning. though he scored the double century in second inning. So they came to me and Wasim and Raven told me that, so are you going to open? So are you ready for that? I said yes. मतलब देखिए और कुछ कुछ तो वसीम टोल्ड मी यार ऐसे हाँ बोलने के लिए मत बोल, करना पड़ेगा. बोले यस आई एम 100% कॉन्फिडेंट, इट्स अ चैलेंज एंड आई लव टू टेक चैलेंजेस, सो मैं करके दिखाऊंगा. एंड देन आई स्कोर्ड लॉट ऑफ 50s ईच एंड एवरी इनिंग एंड देन फाइनल आई गॉट 100. सो दैट इज द स्टोरी ऑफ इट.
Well, I think we can move to the next segment, which is called Mumbai Slangs.
I didn't get to Mumbai Slangs for means.
It's Mr. Samant versus Slang. So now this is going to be a segment where you're going to tell us the meaning. We're going to ask you what it means.
Okay, okay.
And you're going to tell us
Okay. Curtis cricketer is like, you know, like whenever teams required you. And you are performing, you are winning the matches for your team. That is called a Kharus attitude or Kharus cricketer. Because a lot of cricketers, they are good cricketers. But when teams requires you to win matches for your team and you are winning matches for your team, that is called a Kharus Mumbai cricketer.
And Sachin sir usually told us, kaula udaula, what does that mean?
Kawala Udawala is it's like any batsman who's playing, you know, and suddenly he throws his wickets. He is playing some rash shot and going in the air, and you know that is called Kawala Udawala. That is
another word we picked up from the Maidans is Kakri shot.
Kakri shot, yes. Kakri shot is like it's really middle of the bat. You know, you bang it middle of the bat. That is called a Kakri shot. Precious cover drive or straight drive or one, you know, a good chagri in the mid wicket on long on, and the sounds come pop. It is like a Kakri shot. Sounds that count, you know, that sounds it's hear you. That is called a Kakri shot.
Hey, attack Popadwadi hai.
Popatwadi is like a very ordinary kind of attack. Popatwadi player means thik-thak player, like
Baitak.
Baitak is a sweep. Baitak Dili Dhani, a sweep shot, usually a slog sweep or a normal sweep. Baitak.
Okay. Zade kaapna ka hai.
It is also sweep or cut shot. Zade kaapna means aapan maarto ani lagat nahi. जब भी लगता नहीं है शॉट, इट इज कॉल्ड कि बाबा आज हड़क अप तो है, बॉल तो लग नहीं रहा है लेकिन ये काट रहा है, तो कट शॉट और मे बी स्वीप शॉट, धाड़ काटना है, यूजुअली कट शॉट को आता है वो.
अर्धमामा
है?
अर्धमामा है.
अर्धमामा मींस बाउंसर.
ओके. बुंडा मामा है?
बुंडा मामा मींस यॉर्कर. इट इज
यू यूज दिस थिंग.
या अर्धा टाक किंवा मामा दे आला. मामा मीन्स बाउन्सर. बुंदा मीन्स यॉर्कर.
तुम्ही यूज केलं होतं का?
हां, आम्ही सांगायचो की विरुद्ध टाक. विरुद्ध मीन्स साईज बॉलिंग. सो इफ आय एम टेलिंग हिम दॅट बोल्ड गुगली टू हिम, सो आय यूज टू बोल आय यूज टू टेल हिम दॅट विरुद्ध टाक याला. विरुद्ध मीन्स रिवर्स. लेग स्पिन डाल रहा है तो गुगली डाल.
नेक्स्ट वन इज कोमटी प्लेयर.
कोमटी प्लेयर है पुचाट प्लेयर. मीन्स इसमें दम नहीं है. इट्स सेम लाइक पोपटवाड़ी. ये पोपटवाड़ी इसका था अपना स्पेशली विनोद यूज टू स्पीक अ लॉट. पोपटवाड़ी एंड कोमटी. कोमटी प्लेयर है. विनोद यूज टू do all
this things. Is interesting sir, this one slightly difficult. I don't know. Gyanba Tukaram
it is like you know playing legim. So legim dance. So those good outswinger, you're playing like Lazim and beating the ball, you know, beating all the time. So it is called Ganba Tukaram. Means he want to play ball, but ball is not middling. Ball is missing. So he's like a Lazim, Ganba Tukaram.
And do you tell your players, choch maru naku?
Actually, I'm not telling players. A lot of selectors used to tell me be choch maru naku, because I used to, you know, guide the ball in the third man, and I used to get out in slip. So all selectors used to tell me, yaar, choch maru naku, choch maru naku. So choch maru naku means age lau naku.
Manta?
Age mat lagana.
Age mat lagana. Fishing outside.
Fishing outside also.
Choch maru naku. Now this is the last one, sir. Taadi dili.
Yeah?
Taadi dili.
Taadi means clap.
Yeah,
taadi. Taadi de mandir. Okay. Clap. High five.
Okay.
High five.
Sir, Samant versus Lions, you scored a perfect 100%.
Samant versus?
Slangs, that was the name of the segment, and you scored 100% in that.
Yeah.
All are correct.
Yes.
कौन सा slang आ है का जो यहाँ पे नहीं है पर तुम ही use के लेते हो slang. विनोद कामली क्या slang?
पुपटवाड़ी जैसा पुपटवाड़ी बोला जा. क्यों अगर देव बाप्पा बोला जा देव बाप्पा
मंटा.
हाँ God तो कभी कभी ऐसा बोलता देव बाप्पा God को याद करता. हाँ विकेट पे अगर विकेट नहीं गिर रहा है तो देव बाप्पा. और उसका अलग अलग बोईकी करके था बोईकी.
ओके
वो खुद को बोईकी बोलता था बोईकी कम ऑन बोईकी.
ओके
ऐसा वो ये पैटर्न शब्द थे उसके विनोद कामली के. विनोद इज यूज्ड टू यू नो हैव लॉट ऑफ फन ऑन विकेट. ही वाज अ चैंप कैरेक्टर.
नाउ व्हिच डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कोचिंग डू यू फाइंड द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट?
Man management. Yeah, man management is very difficult because when you have to manage lot of all selectors,
yes,
all associations, barriers, media, maybe TV channels. So man management, if you tell me that, frankly speaking, I want to improve in my man management. Really?
Okay.
Yeah. More man management.
Now, best coaching memory that you had so far? Best one moment if you had to figure out. You were the coach and you can never forget that.
I'm a coach who really respect cricketers, because cricketers are my job is there. Because of cricket and cricketers, I'm belongs to there. So when I'm belongs to them, that is my first priority to take care of all cricketers.
Yeah.
So I want to become a good human being first. I don't want to become a good coach or good cricketer. I want to good human being first, and I want to ask my player to become a good human being. Yeah, that is the main perspectives of my coaching ethics. Be a good human being, because when you'll become a good human being, there is no competition in between you and me.
Okay.
Because always we are thinking negative when there is a competition. When you are good human being, there is no competition.
Okay.
So you are team member. When you are team member, you are thinking of the team only, not individual. So that's why good human being is the perspective of my life. Being a good human.
Brilliant, sir. On that note, I would like to say thank you very much
for
joining us.
Thank you very much. Thank you
and
very
I really
much.
Hope, I really hope you love this session as much as I did.
Yeah, definitely. I went to flashback a lot of times. So thanks. Okay. Thanks for the old memories.
Because you gave us a peep into the dressing room of Mumbai in that era, and that was amazing. All those stories.
I was so fortunate.
A lot of learning.
I was so fortunate for that. I was
lucky. Thank you very much, sir, for being.
Thank you, Suhas. Thank you very much for having me. Thanks a lot. Thank you.